awesome fun. She's making everyone a snowy summer day.
Got the Avion margaritas, lime margaritas, and we got some snacks. This is like our favorite thing to do here. We kind of make our own nachos. We get the guacamole con totopos, and then we get the refried beans with no dairy, and then we just kind of dump it on there, and they have some nice hot sauces. There's a chipotle and a verde sauce.
Yeah.
And very responsibly, I got a cup of water. So they have free ice water at all the walk-up locations that have food and snacks and things. They just have it ready just to hand you because they expect people to ask them. So I told Thomas we should get a water with each drink today. Here's Thomas.
Hey, and yeah, sorry about the wind noise. We're right on the lake and I forgot to put the wind muffs on.
I'm not an ears person, but these were so cute. They're all lace, little goth velvet lace, and the little, I can't remember, the point, whatever it's called, little tool back here.
Yeah, you get a tool on your head.
So, I went for it. I couldn't resist. Like Thomas was saying, it seems like they're catering a little bit more to the gothy folk. We've seen a lot of nightmare stuff. And just a lot of stuff that has black in general, like before you can really find things that were black background and that kind of thing.
There's also a lot of like Haunted Mansion stuff now too.
Yeah, we saw like a journal like at the hotel where we're staying. There was a little journal that was all wallpaper, like they've been doing a lot with wallpaper. It's a pretty exciting time to be goth at Disney.
Yeah.
So guess what?
We're back home.
The waterfall isn't over here.
Yeah.
But yeah, the Canada Pavilion reminds us a lot of Seattle. It's got the mountains, it's got the waterfall on the other side. But more importantly, we found out where Thomas's favorite beer is.
It's right there. I have to finish my coffee and Jameson.
Yeah, Thomas got a bonus drink.
Yeah.
He needed a coffee.
Needed caffeine. Also needed a little whiskey, because you can't do Epcot without drinking
alcohol. Booze and all the drinks.
Yeah. So, yeah.
Look at that. It's just like being home. We feel like this is themed out in a very Vancouver, Pacific Northwest sort of way. So it makes us happy. We're gonna go down here to the O Canada Circle Vision.
Hey.
Look at this! The Fiend Mall on draft. And you're even allowed to take it in with you to go watch the O Canada Circle Vision movie. Yes. That's what we're about to do. I really like beer there. We really like Canada. Thanks, Canada.
Just as women and as girls, just as men.
We're here at the Frozen Crown Pub, which is like our favorite place to come. It's always air conditioned, and believe it or not, even though it's 40 degrees this morning, it's now in the 70s. You probably do believe it though, because it's Florida and that's how it's supposed to be.
I have gotten a Jameson shot. She apologized for the plastic shot glass. I said, you know, that's fine. Thomas is waiting for his beer.
I love everything that's got those old English Victorian details, and this is just another place that carries that theming through.
I got the shot of Jameson because it takes me very long to squeeze in the summer. We still have many, many countries to go. What do you say in England?
One of the reasons that we decided to go in the counterclockwise direction today, which is not our usual path, was so that we could get to the UK Pavilion and the Rose and Crown Pub early. Because if you come here at the end of the night, this place, if you've seen our previous video, this place is crazy packed. There's a line around the bar outside, and everyone in here is wasted.
This is usually what does it.
But like right now, it's, what time is it, Thomas?
It's 1:29.
So yeah, it's like midday, and we were able to just walk in here, which has always been the case. Even in the summer, even when it's super busy, if you come in the middle of the day, it's a really nice place to cool down because there's AC in here, and there's not a line. You can just walk right up to the bar. Look, this is the bathroom of the Rose and Crown Pub. It's like my mother lives here.
Merry Christmas, everyone! We are British Revolution. We'll be back shortly at 6 o'clock, but before we leave you, we've got time for one more song. All right, for this last song, we have one question to ask you and one question, and that is who are you?
Vegan, right there on the menu. Can you see that? You can't. I tried. Can you see that? Vegan wrap. Looks delicious. I'm gonna get one of those. Look, they even have their sweets, the vegan ones, right next to where I got my little wrap. That's so awesome. Thomas is really excited because they have the booze here. I'm gonna have a cider. But look at this. They have a vegan flatbread with tofu. We came to the Sunshine Season Food Fair. It's a quick service. They have beer, they have cider here. Here's my vegan wrap. And Thomas got the Guardian Chicken Korma. It smells really great. They also had all kinds of vegan snacks. Sweet chili tortilla chips, sweet potato tortilla chips. They're marked vegan right on the bag. Pretty awesome. Oh, look, it's Thomas.
Hey, it's me.
This is Thomas eating his Guardian chicken.
It's me eating.
Korma, vegetable korma.
Yeah. So there's Guardian.
It smells really good.
Yeah, it's good. It's really good. There's Guardian, there's the peas, green peas, carrots, onions, cauliflower. And what it tastes like a coconut curry. Yeah.
It was only $8.99. And we never had this before, so we decided to come try it. And now I'm gonna try it.
It's really good. It's like I was saying just a second earlier that like it's nothing to like stand out, but it's good for what it is. And it's really awesome that it's available at Disney World. Like it's great that it's available as a vegan option, just on the menu. You don't have to ask for it special or anything. Like it's there.
Yeah. Well, and they have this wrap. And then they had that panini that you could get. It looked really good, but I already had this, so I was like, oh. I'm not going to have Thomas try this because it has cucumbers, and he's not a fan of cucumbers. But I ate it, and it's just like clean, fresh. Like, if you've been eating a lot of crap, like, this is a good, clean eat. It has like a tomato, basil-y kind of wrap or whatever. But I'm curious to try Thomas's.
Oh, casserole.
So we also got these chips. The sweet chili chips are really good. The sweet potato chips. They're just, you know, they're a little more bland in comparison. If it's if you're between the two and you like a little spiciness, I definitely would recommend sweet chili chips. And now I'm gonna try this. I'm just eating this one before.
That's really good.
Oh, look, it's our bus. My feet are killing me.